reflection of the divine family itself, of the moment of creation where divine masculine and divine feminine meet, making and creating more love. But always there must be the focus that itself creates your identity, whether it is focusing on being a limited human being or focusing on being the heart of love. As you recognize that you are this heart, that you are my heart awakening into its truth as love, then every moment that your focus is here in the glorious now moment itself, you are being the living magnet through which love can be drawn into its full embodiment as the great forces of creation become viable and balanced here on earth. Every story is, of course, a metaphor for light and that which light teaches. So the story, beloved ones, of Jesus of Nazareth is actually the story of humanity as Christ. Every year the light has come, flooding into the opening that is created each year. This year is different. It is time, beloved ones, time for the remembrance to be born into consciousness here on earth. So I am asking you to be the fertile womb that holds the gestating embryo of Christ. And from the real, I ask you to recognize that all of humankind is truly one love, and all the rest is all an illusion. As you awaken this love in your heart and for others, the truth will begin to build all around you, heart after heart remembering itself, many voices speaking only love. Every now moment, every heartbeat, you are immersed directly and always by me, and as you pour this life forth into this glorious embryo, you can know that you are true and balanced twin flame love, bringing Christ to birth in all human hearts beginning this Christmas. So two things that I ask of you, two things that call for your focus. One is uniting in consciousness with your twin flames. The other is to be the embodiment here on earth of the spiritual parents. For what is of the spirit is not the physical, and you are ever and always joined in twin flame love. So what I am asking of you is that you open your hearts, make this powerful connection, and use it to embrace all of humanity and bring the Christ to birth consciously in all of humankind through the power, dearest ones, of your focus, and to nourish the Christ child with your love. You will see as this year begins that many things are changing in the world. The most important of these is your own embodiment of living love, and of that which is the great rays of divine masculine and divine feminine, that the world may be loved through you. For you are my access into the realm of time, of duality, and through your love, as you release the little mind, that which is the whole of God I am, the whole of this glorious love shall become visible in the world as the story of the Christ family. No longer the human family, but rather the family of love, giving birth to the innocence and purity of the infant Christ in them, bringing in its nourishment directly from the real, allowing the living Christ to mature and step forth as the one glorious heart of God here on earth. Thank you for your part in this. Thank you for offering your twin flame love. Thank you for being here to demonstrate that this great love can be embodied through the consciousness of who you really are. Let your prayers, your focus, your Christness this Christmas be completely for this awakening to love of the whole of humankind, which is my living heart. Each twin flame heart itself is the great heart of God, your heart awakening to love. Thank you for remembering. And so it is.
Always go further, seeking the truth. The secret in its depth, as if what we thought we knew was what we knew least. A waterfall, a mountain, an infinite sequence, a universe here and not there, like an eternity. Water, mountains, forest, and the gods of the forest. To go elsewhere is to go beyond the very idea we have of the idea. see otherwise, live differently, and discover. That's how we find out who we really are. The real begins at the heart of things. Yee-hoo.
Now, today I'm going to be talking about sizzler. Not just sizzler, but music in general. You know, from time to time, I cover these topics. Like I tell you now, a timeline enough people either forget, because it looks like everybody has shot in memory, or they just don't know, right? They were not alive when it happened. Might be wondering, hold on. So they were over the plaque burning on the DJ from Ford. No, that's not my lane. But I was watching a video on United Games channel, Two Locks, and he was talking about SZA. And as a matter of fact, SZA, I realized that most people don't remember, right, that SZA. Because when Two Locks are talking, I realized that he was talking about that SZA. Which SZA? 97 SZA. You see, if I went around, I understand, you can't hold it against it. When me and people say music, you can't influence nothing on music. By now, if you know, that's rubbish. Entertainers by their own actions, sure you say, music can influence, and music is powerful, and music can this, and music can that. But they only have a problem with some type of lyrics, some type of songs. Right? When it's against informers, it's just words. When it's against the rainbow community, then it's murder music and people are now at risk. So let me give you a case study of not society saying music is powerful and can influence, but the entertainers themselves. Yes, the same entertainer now will tell us that this is just art, it's just entertainment, it's just words, it can't influence nothing. The same people ever tell you that? Nobody now tell us that in a 97, they were saying something else. 97, 98, 99. Who remember? Let me jog on the memory. In 99.